رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. اللهم ربنا إنك عفو كريم تحب العفو فاعف عنا. اللهم عافنا واعف عنا. يا الله, you are the one who forgive and pardon and you love to pardon. فيا الله, forgive us all our sins in these blessed days. يا أكرم الأكرمين يا رب العالمين. We are the night of the 23rd, which is a night of Laylatul Qadr. So, Layali al-Qadr, all of the last 10 days, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, seek or try to catch Laylatul Qadr in the last 10 days. And then, more specifically, in the odd nights, like tonight. And then Ibn Abbas has confirmed, according to his narration, radiyallahu ta'ala anhuma, that Laylatul Qadr is the ninth of the 27. However, the believer, every night is Laylatul Qadr. Because these, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't disclose this blessed night to any of the nations before, but honoring the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and his ummah, to give them this space or this time of the last 10 days. Therefore, whatever you have done so far is very good, but multiply it, because it is soon is going to come to an end. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us a life to witness the Eid, multiply your effort and your worship. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in Surah Sa'd that we were reciting, قَالَ كِتَابٌ أَنزَلْنَاهُ مُبَارَكٌ. This book that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down that we are reciting, and always relate to the life of the people around you, relate to the faith of people around you who are following. If there's any faith on earth that they recite their book once a year, in a congregation like this. This is, subhanAllah, one of the elements that you know that this, of course, is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but you have blessing, as we have said already, that many people, when they see such a thing, they wish to be or to wish to have this in their religion. قَالَ كِتَابٌ أَنزَلْنَاهُ مُبَارَكٌ. This book we have sent down, Mubarak, Mubarak, blessed. And al-baraka is the infinite of goodness and good. So whatever you need, you know, in every aspect of your life or of the hereafter, you need some baraka, some good is in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Qala liyadabbaru ayata. So li, it's like the illa, the reason of the sending down is to reflect and ponder on the verses, on the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Indeed, only be reminded the people of understanding. إِنَّمَا يَتَذَكَّرُوا أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ. Now, one of the questions that we need to reflect on, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all along Surah As-Saffat, He's saying, إِنَّا كَذَلِكَ نَجْزِي الْمُحْسِنِينَ. This is how we do reward the muhsinin. Who are the muhsinin? The excellent in ibadah, the good doer in the action, those in constant striving, those who have the most power in patience, those who have the peak of the humility to Allah. So these are the best ever human being created and walked on earth, who are the messengers of Allah. So when you say, إِنَّ كَذَلِكَ نَجْزِي الْمُحْسِنِينَ, this is how we reward you as a muhsin. Now, if you think someone, for example, from the people of the dunya, can tell him, say, I'm going to reward you, what do you think we're going to expect? He says, how much money are you going to give me? Right? So the thing, when you say people reward, so the reward is need to be quantified, something that they touch, something they're going to use. And mostly people, they love money. Yeah? Love money. Because most of the people, the deity that they really trust, you know, is called the dollars. Actually, it is on the dollar. They've written the God we trust. So the rewards, subhanAllah, quantified. If you come to a small child and say, I'm going to reward you, what do you think he's going to expect? So depends on one's expectation, which is this expectation comes from one's perception, one's dreams, one's love, what you love in this dunya. So what you love in this dunya, that's what you want to be rewarded from. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inviting you to ponder and reflect. قَالَ إِنَّكَ ذَلِكَ نَجْزِي الْمُحْسِنِينَ. For Nuh alayhi salam, how was he rewarded? 950 years of struggle, 950 years of striving, 950 years of hardship, 950 years people, they call him names. He's the insane. He's the oldest person. Don't listen to him. The last will of every father and every mother, do not follow that insane person. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, this is how we reward Nuh. Where the reward? Then Ibrahim alayhi salam. Ibrahim facing his father, his people, all his people, all the town, all the city, all the nation. Imagine a whole nation, you see it in the news, that we're going to burn the most despicable person in our nation called Ibrahim. Everybody is happy. Everyone taking like even a piece of fire to throw it to contribute in this, you know, great nation or cause of nation to burn Ibrahim. Subhanallah. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved him, and he is facing one of the biggest trial ever, which is to slaughter his son. And after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, right after that, said, قَالَ إِنَّكَ ذَلِكَ نَجْزِي الْمُحْسِنِينَ. This is how we reward the good doers. So Allah rewarding Ibrahim by get him to slaughter his son. Then Musa and Harun, the hardship they have with Fir'aun, the hardship of subhanAllah, their journey of migration, and then the hardship Musa and Harun, they get from their own people, they make subhanAllah a sanam, an idol, and so on. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the end said, this is how we reward the muhsinin. Elias the same is facing people who like worshipping and adoring a calf, qala ba'lan. And you leave the one who created the heaven and the earth, and they denied him, they rejected him. And he was striving and going through hardship. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قَالَ إِنَّكَ ذَلِكَ نَجْزِي الْمُحْسِنِينَ. And Lut, only with his family, even his wife came against him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved him from those people. And he said, إِنَّكَ ذَلِكَ نَجْزِي الْمُحْسِنِينَ. I mean, we have mentioned the story, how Lut alayhi salam was in such, subhanallah, horrific, and very difficult situation to face, you know, his people, all of them coming, subhanAllah, to rape, literally to rape the guest of Lut. It's good to use that word to see how big it is. Inna kadhalika najzi al-muhsinin. Yunus alayhi salam, just because his people, they were stubborn, they didn't want to listen, he left. He said, these people, there is no need to be. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made him to go through trial. And subhanAllah, he was, as all of you know, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, in the belly of the well. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala get him out, قَالَ وَهُوَ سَقِيمَ. I mean, he was sick. He cannot even move. Took him a long time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought this tree that planted next to him of yaqtin. And he was eating from it to gain back his strength, you know, rebuild his muscles so he can walk. Inna kadhalika najzi al-muhsinin. So how can we understand this reward for us to be inspired? I mean, when people, for example, someone is saying, I'm going to reward you, someone who's looking for fame, is to give him really something like, you know, a big name. To be known, to be, you know, invited everywhere. Someone who's looking for power, his true reward is to be president, to be a king, and people who see them, they making these campaigns, and they spend, you know, billions and tons of money just to get to that position. So what is the ihsan? What is the jaza? What is this reward that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking to us about it? Therefore, we need to erase everything we know about the dunya. It's nothing of what we look. That's why the Quran gives you the perception of another world, which is the reality, the truth. What we live here is a fiction, it's an illusion. So the first thing, dear brother, respected sister, قال إن كذلك نجزي المحسنين, he rewarded them by selecting them to go through this trial. That's a great reward. Now imagine when in a country, for example, they want to select a team to represent them. They're going to select any person. They're going to select the most skilled in that, you know, game, whatever. And they're going to go through hardship, you know, a camp, and they don't do this. And they feel so pride. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the reward that He's selecting them for that tribe. That's the first reward. So then when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have you to go through trial, He's selecting you for that trial. That's why the Prophet ﷺ قال أَشَدُّ بَلَاءً الْأَنْبِيَاءَ. The most people who go through trial are the prophets, and then the closest to them, which is mean here the trial is a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as selected you to be a source of inspiration for others, to be someone who really, you know, build your personality to be stronger. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is helping you to be a better person, to be a greater person, to be a stronger person. The second jaza, قَالَ يَجْزِيَهُمْ قَالَ بِأَنْ يُوَجِّهَ قُلُوبَهُمْ وَيَرْفَعَهَا إِلَى مُسْتَوَى الْوَفَى. He rewarded them by directing their hearts toward, you know, be elevated to complete the trust with Allah, to be fully, completely faithful to Allah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He elevates you. How much you do for Allah. And you know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want to reward you, so He want to elevate you higher by a trial. There is a story that has helped us to understand this part. Musa alayhi salam, this has been narrated, every time he passed through a path, he will see a worshipper always praying. He does not. He's always making ibadah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One day he passed, he didn't see him. He was wondering, but subhanAllah, he saw kind of part of bodies. Then he realized something happened to this person. So he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to understand. He said, yes, yeah, Musa, that person, worshipper that you saw, has been attacked by a beast. He said, Ya Rabbi, he's been worshipping you all the time. He said, Ya Musa, he asked me for a high level of paradise. All the deeds he's doing with worship, he will never be able to get that deed. So he went through the trial of the beast for Allah to grant him that high level he requested. Subhanallah, then the trial to Ibrahim and Nuh and Ilyas and Lut is to elevate them. Then subhanallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will reward them by give them the empowerment of patience and of striving, so they complete the action in the way that Allah will be pleased with them. So Allah, when He get you to trial, He will give you all the provision. You need sabr, He's going to give it to you. You need some, subhanAllah, sweetness of iman in your heart to help you endure the difficulty, He's going to give it to you. قَالَ وَيَجْزِيَهُمْ بِإِقْدَارِهِمْ وَإِصْبَارِهِمْ عَلَى الْأَدَىٰ. Help them to fulfill it. And the last one, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He reward them to be worthy of the great reward that is awaiting them in the hereafter. Because if you say, Ya Allah, give me al-firdaus al-a'la. طيب, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala قال, أَمْ حَسِبْتُمْ أَن تَدْخُلُ الْجَنَّةِ. Do you think that you're going to paradise without being tested, without listening and hearing about the people, righteous people before you, how they went through perversity, through poverty, through calamities, to the point that the messenger among them will say, when is the help of Allah is coming him and the believer? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, the help of Allah is near. The help of Allah when you elevate yourself. The help of Allah when you get at the honoring of yourself. When you're going to be deserving the reward of Allah. Therefore, when you come back, when you come to the hereafter, as in the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, every dua you make, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answers you. Then, when you come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will remind you every dua you made. He said, this one, you didn't get it in the dunya, but you get in exchange this and this and this. And this trial, when you have patience, then you make dua, and you didn't get what you asked for, because you said, Ya Allah, give me relief right now. And it went on for another 2, 3, 4 years. He said, but I give you this. So subhanAllah, after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala disclosed to him the great wisdom for all what he went through in his life, and the dua that he made, and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he answered them, he said, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the mu'min, the believer, said, I wish Allah didn't give me anything in the dunya, and he stored it to me, save it to me in the akhirah. For may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from the muhsineen. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the understanding to know who are the muhsinoon, and to make, insha'Allah ta'ala, asking Allah the right dua to help us be elevated at the level of the muhsinin. Nas Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for people who... there is someone who passed away, you know, close relative to our people here in Nairobi. Nas Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to shower them with his mercy. Also, a young lady passed away. She had cancer. Nasa Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala an yaghfir lahum wa yarhamhum. Her janazah is tomorrow at Burnsville. Nasa Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala an yaghfir lahum dunubahum. Allahumma akrim nuzulahum. Allahumma wassa' mudkhalahum. Allahumma akrim nuzulahum. Allahumma wassa' mudkhalahum. Allahumma rabbana asihhum bimaghfiratik. اللهم ربنا باعد بينهم وبين ذنوبهم كما باعدت بين المشرق والمغرب اللهم أدخلهم في رحمتك وارزقهم جنات النعيم إنك أنت أرحم الراحمين وصل اللهم وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما وجزاكم الله خير.